Welcome to Nano Matters, the podcast that explores examples of nanotechnology. I'm Lisa Friedersdorf, Director of the National Nanotechnology Coordination Office. Here with me today is Ange Akono, Assistant Professor of Civil and Environmental Engineering at Northwestern University. So, Ange, I understand your research is looking at the performance of concrete. Can you tell us a little bit about what you're studying?
So I'm looking at the behavior of concrete at really small land scales, and I want to be able to understand how to make concrete stronger, tougher, durable, and better. But I'm also looking at what are alternatives to concrete. Right now, it's really the most consumed material worldwide after water, literally.
So how does nanotechnology play a role?
That's a very good question. Nanotechnology enables us to understand the behavior of concrete. And let me kind of pause a little bit and explain the difference between concrete and cement. So cement is an important ingredient in concrete. So to make concrete, you have to mix cement with water, and then you have stone and sand in this case. So I have a broad range of projects. So I can work both on concrete, either on the aggregates or on the cement or on the connect, on the interaction. And then there's a significant amount on the cement. In this case, so nanotechnology, there's kind of this dual role. One of them is really being able to quantify the performance at the fundamental land scale and understand structure property relationships. In a nutshell, if we change the design or the processing, how is this going to influence the performance, not only at the small land scale, but also at the macroscopic land scale, not only in the short term, but also in the longer term? That is one aspect. And then once we have that fundamental understanding, then we can really start playing engineering and say, okay, so now how can we try to play with it? How can we tune different buttons? How can we change the ingredient a little bit? How can we have different type of soup? And can we predict how is this going to change the behavior, the appearance, the properties of concrete or cement?
So what types of properties are you looking at, and how does nanotechnology play a role in those properties?
One of the dominant properties that is the focus of my lab is fracture. And that is because fracture is really pervasive. Everything ultimately breaks. So then using that thought, we can try to do some type of reverse engineering. If we understand how it breaks at different land scale, then maybe we can prevent it from breaking if this is the application. Typically, when we're thinking about construction material, we want to prevent it from breaking in this case. And this is where nanotechnology is very important, because fracture is intrinsically multi-scale. So the large crack that we can see, for instance, in the pavement, well, it actually started as really a fundamental breaking of atomic atoms, you know, at the molecular land scale. If we can understand how it is propagating and how that propagation is influenced either by the chemistry, by the environment, by the microstructure, then we can also play some type of reverse engineering and preventing from propagating.
When you're talking about fracture and the different length scales of fracture or crack, what nanomaterial ingredients are you putting in, and what role do they play in resisting fracture?
What we've seen recently in our lab is that if we use carbon-based nanomaterials, so it's been either graphene nanoplatelets or carbon nanofibers, then we can enhance the fracture resistance. And there are two ways that this happens. One of them is because the material can bridge the crack in this case. So you can think of, if you have a fracture, you're going to have a carbon nanofiber that's going to be standing within it, or you're going to have a graphene nanoplatelets. And in terms of dimension, like carbon nanofiber, the diameter can be hundreds of nanometers, and the length is kind of tens of microns. And the graphene nanoplatelets in this case, the thickness is like 4 nanometers, and then the size could be like 40 nanometers times 40 nanometers in this case. So we really have kind of this bridging effect that is occurring, but it can also kind of lead to what we call toughening mechanisms, where you can bridge crack, you can have micro cracking, you can have a roughening the crack front, which means that locally you have a higher surface area that is occurring. So it makes it harder to be able to propagate the crack. That is one way. The other way that nanomaterials improve the resistance to fracture is just because they have a high reactive surface area. So because of the surface area, they're going to accelerate the reaction of cement, and they're really going to change the DNA of cement per se to promote building blocks that will lead to higher resistance to fracture.
So when I think of a bulk concrete bridge or a large structure, I think of the addition of rebar, right? So a bar that helps take some of the load, I think helps with some of the tensile forces where the concrete's better with compression. So on the very small length scales of these multi-scale cracks, do the carbon fibers play a similar role to what a rebar would do on a large scale?
That is a great analogy. And the answer is yes. That's really amazing. When we observe it using electron microscopy, we really have this mesh where you have cement hydration grains, and they're going to be connected by nanomaterial, carbon nanofiber, graphene nanoplatelets. So this is going to influence the strength, but also it's going to bridge the pores. So when you think of bridging the pores, another criterion of performance in this case is resistance to water penetration. Because again, water is very harmful for concrete in this case. But because you have those nanomaterials that create that mesh, it makes it much harder for water to go inside the cement in this case and create any type of damage. So another aspect is really synthesis. We've been working in my lab is trying to develop advanced synthesis method, because that is the ideal vision. You want to be able to have this neat mesh where you have your cement grain, hydrated cement grain, and then you have the nanomaterials. But the issue is that nanomaterial likes to stay together. They like to stay friends and be in the group isolated. So what we're trying to do is to really disperse them, to say, well, actually, we want you to go into the cement and make friends with cement, not with yourself. and really, we have to work in the lab and try to find what is the correct mixing procedure, what is the correct processing procedure to be able to reach that result.
So I liked your description of how you're encouraging the nanomaterials to disperse evenly in the cement. Where do you see the future of your research leading? I mean, where do you think it will have an impact?
That's a very good question. Right now, we've been working a lot on just lab applications, just trying to kind of work on different type of formulations in this case. There's definitely a lot more questions that we have to answer. For instance, characterizing the performance using broader design space, looking at long-term performance, resistance to high temperature, trying to think of multifunctionality, like the advantage with carbon-based nanomaterial, you can have enhanced electrical conductivity. So for instance, can you use it to be able to make a sensor, or can you use it to be able to transform the wall into a battery? So there's kind of different ways, just kind of working in the lab. And then the other point is trying to kind of scale it up. Can we scale up our procedure? Can we work at the structural level? You were talking about kind of concrete beams. The small specimen that I have in my lab, can I turn them into larger beams that will have improved performance? And can we test them in the field in this case? And then there's the other aspect of commercialization. Can I kind of launch a startup and then try commercializing the product? So there are different directions that are possible. In this case, I haven't yet decided.
Well, I have to say that I will never look at concrete and cement in the same way again. And I just appreciate so much you taking the time to talk with us.
My pleasure. Thank you again for inviting me.